before jumping into FSM design, we need to know why we go for finite state machine. Let's say we want to design a chip for automated teller machine. You must be familiar with the ATM. You insert your credit card or debit card, you get the cash. But actually, it's not going to be very simple and straightforward like this. There could be many possible scenarios. For example, you inserted your card but pressed wrong PIN number. Then what would happen? Or if someone is trying to misuse your credit card, then how it has to protect your information, user identity? Or the machine is running out of cash, then what would happen? So like this, you have to think through various possible scenarios. Now, when it comes to finite state machine, what actually we do is we define each scenario as particular state. So this FSM will go through many states. So to design finite state machine, you have to identify the possible scenarios and you need to define each scenario as state. Then how the transition is going to happen. You give some set of inputs and based on the inputs, the machine will get into a particular state. And for each state, we are going to define particular output. That's how fundamentally this FSM works. So what we do is we understand the functionality and then based on the functionality, we define FSM with multiple states. Now let's look at this example, how this ATM chip works. When you put on power, this ATM will be initialized with ideal state. This is the initial state and everything is going to happen from this ideal state. Now this machine is out of service, so automatically it gets into out of service state and then automatically it comes back to ideal state. You inserted your card, the machine is working fine. It gets into PIN entry state. You pressed wrong PIN, so automatically it goes back to ideal state. If you press valid PIN, it gets into next state. Then based on the type of transaction, it will get into different state. You want to check the balance. You don't want to withdraw money. So it gets into a state called display balance. After displaying the balance, automatically it goes back to ideal state. Now